is hosting us.
As you know, we are the board of directors, and obviously.
us everything. As soon as possible. If you have a crazy idea for improving our large part of our community, feel free to talk with us. And if you have a question, obviously, if you want to know the deal, so right moment. You are too shy. Maybe it's the lack of coffee in the morning.
Yes, sir. It wasn't enough coffee, maybe it's maybe later.
Later, yeah.
Please.
Yes, please. my cloth should be Christian, but no, we all know as cloth. So okay, Christian but cloth. I think the I'm Vito, then we have Cisco. This one is our team and the people that usually work daily. Do a lot for everything that is working behind the foundation. They take care of the marketing, they take care of the infrastructure, localization, everything that can be important for the daily life of our project, but also our product. Because, for example, with ICO and the design team, we can also improve our software. So,
thank you and welcome to the LibreOffice Conference. But in discussions with Erion to see and Erion changes, I've come to one conclusion. The most difficult logistical operation in transforming a city is not a big square or a big boulevard. It's a space of 10 centimeters, which is between your 2 ears. That is the most difficult infrastructure project in the city. And I think what I found with your conference, the legal conference, I think that the biggest effort is not about software, it's not about where we store stuff in the cloud, it's not about the whole open source technology. But it's about how to change mentality, ways of life that we've had for a long time. Tradition, propaganda, and dogma that has been fed through a lot of the corporate enterprise community for so many years. And I think one of the challenges of defining the city of Tirana, although a huge number of people have moved now to open source, 80% almost, I think, of municipality is running open source platforms, the Nextcloud and Google, and all that really nice stuff. But I think a lot of the inertia is about changing the mentality of our workers, of our staff. I remember when I ran for office 3 years ago, I asked people, I said, who wants change? Everybody raised their hands. I want change in our area. And then you win and you come in office and then you say, now, who wants to change? People say, have heard about change first. It's easier to change. You know me, I'm a bit different. And then you can change, and then you need that change, but I will change us. Because change doesn't sound like a very sexy living thing, unless it involves you. When it involves you, change becomes true. So I see this a lot as an exercise of change, and change in mentality, and change in the way we're doing things. So we are very excited to be a leading municipality to go on open source. And I think it's about time to involve others. Because I said, like Albania, it's a love affair. But love affair needs to be spread. And I know we need to do more with schools, which is communities that we sort of manage, and we send them to leaders, and maybe we should be able to encourage schools to follow this initiative. And one of the biggest things that we are trying to do at the pyramid, which was the former mausoleum of Enver Hoxha, the former dictator, was never used as a mausoleum, by the way. But he would still be rolling in his grave if he found out that we'd be using that beautiful space in the heart of the city, which is the most precious real estate in Tirana, as a center to be doing more of this. So basically, upscale what we're doing here in Oficina, give it a central location, and focus mostly on the younger generation. We're trying to target the age between 10 and 18 when it comes to programming, when it comes to virtual reality, augmented reality, artificial intelligence, robotics, informatics in general. So I really hope that you will become a future partner of this space. And of course, we don't want to exclude anyone, but we want to make sure that open source technology also has a space on the table. And I think preparing the next generation to move up, our mission is not to remain a country that sold shoes and shirts for the rest of our generation. We need to be able to ask. I think the advantage of being disadvantaged is that we can leapfrog. Instead of going through all the layers of technology from the 80s and 90s and 2000s and 2K and whatnot, we can leapfrog towards now the latest trend in open source and technology. So I look very forward to get some recommendations. We've had some amazing hackathons, and I think a lot of that has become an amazing contribution for the city. But I really hope that what will come out of this conference maybe be some tools that we can also use for the city. Other than that, I really hope we get some free time to go out and about. It's an exciting place. It's not the most beautiful or the most modern, but it's definitely one of the most exciting home cities you've ever seen. I know it's my job to sleep highly of my city. It reminds me of that joke. How many of you know that camel joke? No one knows the camel joke? Can I tell you the camel joke? Alright, so the camel joke goes like this. There's two Bedouins who meet in the desert, in the Sahara. And one of them has a camel. And he tells his friend, he says, look, this is the best camel ever in our desert. That was so special with your camel. My camel is so cool, it will walk for 100 miles without taking a rest. This cannot be easy. It's practically impossible. Not only that, he can probably go for 1 month without drinking any water. Okay. 1 month of Of course, they can resist for no 1 month. Not only that, he can go 1 year without having any food. This is impossible. So, 100 miles walk without rest, 1 month without the water, a year without food. How much for your camel? Because you know, it's like my child. I need someone to camel, just like that. So, no, come on, every dear thing has a price. Tell me how much does your camel cost. So, he gives him a exuberant amount of money for the price of the camel. He buys the camel, and then after a month, they meet in another oasis in the Sahara. And after they meet that, the guy who bought the camel is furious. He's fuming, literally smoke coming out of his ears. He sees the other guy and says, "You are such a cheater." "What do you mean?" "I cannot believe you sold me this camel for such a high price." He said, "What's wrong with the camel?" "You know, it drinks and eats like a pig. It will not move its ass until I kick it. You know, it's total fraud." And the guy says, "Never speak bad of your camel, because you will never be able to sell it." Something on the roof, but this will be up to you. Have a great conference.